So, here we have Frankie B. Flat. Now here's the thing, one might mistake him for one of those victims, cause he's one of those cuddly old grandpa types. However, he is very paranoid about everyone not on his side, and as such, he's quite zealous in peddling his horseshit to everyone he meets, and as such, even his friends and family seem to be quite fed up with it. Probably because he keeps pestering his grandchildren, as everyone else as well, planting seeds, as he likes to call it. Today, on the other hand, we are going to have a look at his paranoia. So what have you got for us, Mr. Frankie?
Hello again, all my brothers and sisters, on our flat, domed, stationary Earth.
Well, that's a first. I'll be right back.
Well, I haven't done a video in a while, but I've been watching.
Quite. So have I, my good man.
A lot of flat earthers out there watching their channels, and I want to say again, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Well, this video is about YouTube. I noticed they're taking a lot of channels down.
Something about YouTube policies in terms of servers comes to mind. I mean, for your channel to be taken down, you must have done something wrong.
Deleting a lot of videos, especially on mine.
Especially on yours? You still have a lot of videos online, and if you now do a 3-strikeout on the YouTube terms of service or policies, your channel will be taken down. So how come your channel is still here?
They took took a lot of my videos down.
Well, you don't strike me as a bandwagon specialist, but are you jumping on bandwagons here? Is this some kind of victim card he's pulling?
Especially the ones that had a lot of viewers on it. I had one with 82,000 viewers and a few others, but they're gone. Just like a fart in the wind, man. They disappeared.
Well, sir, I've had a gander at your videos and your channel, so first of all, let's throw this 82,000 views video on here. I do believe it's still online now, isn't it, Mr. Frankie? So that video was uploaded just over a year ago on April the 18th, 2018, and the video I'm responding to right now is uploaded on the 23rd of March, 2019. Now let's also have a look at your Social Blade views, shall we? I mean, 82,000 views, that should be quite a dip in your total views, because that is what happens when you have a video removed, those views also get removed from your total views, and that dip will still be there even if you manage to get that video back online. Well, would you look at that, Mr. Frankie, you wouldn't be lying to us now, would you?
And for what reason?
Well, it kind of depends on what car you drive. Is it a bandwagon?
This is America. Free speech.
Oh yes, I completely agree. Free speech is one of our most precious rights we have. However, YouTube is a private company, so they can do this. If they did, because frankly, my dear Frankie, they haven't done anything to your channel or your video, so, you know.
That really bothers me.
You want to know what bothers me, Mr. Frankie? You, outright lying with a straight face, just because you heard something about Flat Earth censorship, and you thought, hey, maybe I can play my victim card. Because there's a little thing called the YouTube Analytics, and of course third-party sites like Social Blade, who basically keep track of the health status of your channel and growth and all kinds of pretty spiffy stuff, to be quite honest. But in your case, it kind of backfired now, didn't it?
And it's the time we're living in. Exactly what our Lord said they would do to us.
Yes, quite. So here's the deal, Mr. Frankie. There is no conspiracy against Flat Earth, or censorship as you like to call it. I, for one, am still getting plenty of Flat Earth video recommendations. I mean, I found yours, didn't I? Not to mention, all YouTube is doing is trying to avoid ticking off their advertisers, who want nothing to do with your fancy little conspiracy of Flat Earth. That is not censorship. That's just business as usual.
You know, but I'm gonna still put out videos, still gonna talk about the Flat Earth, and our Lord.
As is well within your right. Not to mention you should keep doing that, of course. But I have a question for you. What does your Lord and Savior say about lying?
And if they want to delete them, fine. I'll just keep putting them up.
Well, I hate to say it, but deleting is not the word you're looking for. Oh hell, the ironic thing is YouTube would even tell us when you yourself deleted the video, if it was removed by some kind of copyright strike or other violation according to the YouTube's terms and service. And, there it is.
Do what my brother did, Daniel Platt.
Well, apart from you completely mispronouncing his name, Daniel Platt himself is a very toxic and vile creature who uploads really stupid videos. Demonstrably stupid, even. So if you are a fan of him, I've got bad news for you, buddy.
It's just drama.
Pratt. Well, I've got bad news for you as well, buddy. Ready for another Pratt fail there? I guess Pratt was born ready for Pratt fails. Huh, yeah.
To start another video over and over again.
Yes, because the production value of his videos is off the chart. Except it's going the wrong direction on this chart.
That's it. I just keep putting them out there. It really pisses me off.
Wait, what? Him putting videos out there pisses you off? Did I miss something here? I probably missed something here.
And especially, I mean, you can see it everywhere.
What?
Where they honor the globe. I mean, it's everywhere.
Where they honor the globe? What is he going on about? Also, you seem to be honoring the globe, according to that Action Comics there in the background. Did you hear of a little newspaper called The Daily Planet?
And I can see it, and I'm sure you girls and guys could see it. And even on the TV, and newspaper, magazines, and you name it, everywhere.
That's so nostalgic. What about the internet?
And it's really frustrating. It really actually gets me mad because...
So, let me get this straight. You're getting mad because of balls? Or rather, ball worship. I didn't even know where I was going with that. But hell, here we are.
I can't pick up the newspaper. I can't reread it anymore.
Why? Is the newspaper too heavy because something you don't believe in? Or could it be you forgot where your reading glasses are? I don't know.
But looking at TV, they honor the globe so much and...
But I have no idea where it's going with this. They honor the globe. What does that even mean?
If I say anything, people get mad.
Well, that kind of depends on what you said. Well, I'm guessing it's about flat earth and you constantly droning around when people ask you to stop. Mostly because they don't care. People could get mad in that case, yeah.
I mean, like, tomorrow, for an example, is my birthday. I'll be 64.
Well, congratulations there, Mr. Frankie.
And usually I have a few people and friends call me even a day or two before my birthday to make sure that they... wish me a happy birthday, just in case if they forget or if they're busy.
Well, these days we have Facebook to remind us. Even people we don't know, we can basically congratulate and, you know, I know where you're going with this. It's kind of annoying that we are living our lives on social media. Is that the thing you're going on about?
None of them. No calls, no nothing.
Well, I mean, what happened, Mr. Frankie? There must be a reason why they don't call you anymore. Because here's assuming they used to call you. So, something happened.
I want to see what happens tomorrow on my birthday. And I really don't care if they're mad at me, if they don't want to talk to me no more.
Well, you clearly care about it. Why are you shooting the thing?
It doesn't bother me. Because I did that one video.
Alright, hold up for a moment here. Why did I get shot off screen? I know it was contradicting, but still. It wasn't silly. Or kinda. Maybe. Why are you shooting the thing again?
You know, I stick with flat earth at all costs.
Well, I can kind of relate with me shining a light on sillies at all costs. Son of a...
I mean, if everybody wants to be mad at me, my friends, my family, then so be it. Be mad at me. And with YouTube, you want to keep taking down my videos? Go ahead.
Fine, I'll go back out there. Kao is doing a good job, though. I mean, seriously, he is not making any points, and he's still doing the same thing as he did in the beginning of the video. That was a good job there, Kao. Now get out of here.
Because I'm not of this world anyway.
Wait, what? Why? Come on!
I know a lot of people out there, the true believers in our Lord, are now constantly in prayer.
Alright, what's the deal here? You guys are overdoing it a little bit, aren't you? Also, constantly in prayer? Well, that's gonna do you a lot of good.
And waiting for his return or the rapture to get us out of here.
Oh yeah, it's only been about 2,000 years or more. Less? Maybe less. However, does this look like the face of a man who cares? Oh, jeez, man, why do you want to get out of here? This is a suicide. Oh, wait, you of course have a clause in your Bible contract that you are not allowed to kill yourself, because then you would not get into the special place called heaven. Why am I even spending time on this nonsense? All right, carry on, Mr. Frankie.
Because we can see all the stuff that's happening.
Or, now stay with me here, you want to see the stuff that you want to see. That was right? I think it was right. You know what I mean, right?
Especially me, being almost 64, I've seen the world change big time.
Oh, I bet you did. I just am wondering what will happen if you turn 66. Let's hope that is not a scary number for you. And I can only imagine the things you've seen change, but it seems like you think change is scary, which is, I guess, human nature, some kind of weird phobia we have. Tell me, you aren't one of those old guys who goes,
you know, back in my day, kids weren't running around chasing cars.
And even though that doesn't make sense, kids are currently playing around on their phone, bumping into cars. So there's that.
And I try to explain it to the younger kids, my grandchildren, my niece and nephews, and it's so hard to reach them. It really is.
So I'm wondering how their parents or your children and nieces and nephews, or perhaps cousins, actually respond to that. I mean, based on you no longer having contact with them, it kind of goes to show they are probably entirely fed up with your horseshit there, Mr. Frankie. And my guess, and this is my guess, they have asked you to stop, and you just keep going on and on and on, while of course wondering why they are pissed off.
I mean, I get a little bit of their attention, at least I get them to start at least looking into it.
So, I thought you lost contact with them, but now you do have contact with them and still keep pestering them, sowing the seeds of your religion. I mean, don't get me wrong, you might be their granddad or uncle, but, you know, there comes a point where Uncle Frankie or Grandpa Frankie is no longer being seen as the funny man, but the annoying man who constantly keeps pushing his narrative onto their children. Now, I can't judge this situation because I only hear one side, but still, it sounds like you are doing something here which is not appreciated at all.
And I can only pray that that little seed grows into a redwood tree, because they really need to know, and everybody needs to know.
Yes, and here's my problem with that. The earth is not flat, and you keep pushing it as being fact, when it is demonstrably not flat. Also, here's one of my biggest problems. You are kind of a victim, also walking the line of being a zealot, while entirely unable to do any form of self-reflection, and of course blame everyone else for your problems, the problems you actually create yourself.
That you've been lied to big time. How could you not see it?
Well, mostly because I understand the issues at hand and you do not. And as such, you think everyone lies to you because you're incapable of understanding. Do your research. Might want to look into what that actually means.
How could you even going outside and just looking at the sky, the chemtrails?
Oh, you're one of those. Those are contrails. God damn it.
And the cost of everything and the way that people are today.
Well, holy hell, Mr. Frankie. That might be the first thing you said throughout this entire video that actually makes sense. I would love for people to be more involved with each other instead of this egocentric and isolationist society, mostly living through their social media and all that kind of stuff. I mean, this is social media, but still, we are a little bit too involved into the social media instead of real life. So, well done.
Everybody's in a rush and time is moving super fast.
Well, I could make a time is relative joke here, but I ran out of time. I'm not even sorry. Well, maybe now I am.
And this is what the Lord told us, all these things would happen.
Nifty, so you have his phone number. Could you send it to me, because I have a few very important questions for this fella. If he is the big old space engineer he is claimed to be, right? Well, what's the matter, Mr. Frankie? Am I not allowed to speak to your fancy man?
So, stay in prayer.
Well, no. I'd rather have his phone number.
Keep talking about the flat earth and our Lord.
Well, you know what's kind of ironic? You are claiming that the Lord, your Lord, thinks the earth is flat. That would make God a flat earther. And the flat earth is demonstrably false. So what does that say about your omnipotent, all-knowing God? It sounds like he's applying to become a jester in the Order of the Sillies as well. Interesting. Although I'm pretty sure you guys are putting words in his non-existent mouth. And did I just out-paradox myself? Holy hell, that's pretty funny.
Because our reward is coming. And remember, all things must pass until our Lord appears.
Oh well, whatever happens, happens. And as such, welcome to the Order of the Silius, Mr. Frankie, or rather Frankie B. Flat. I hope you enjoy your stay. Although I do have a bit of advice, that is, if you come across this video, you might want to have a look at one of my other videos called Dangers of the Flat Earth Cult, the Zealots, Charlatans and Victims, which is kinda a video all flurs must see. Except you, Pratt. Bye bye. I actually almost forgot about that. Anyway, Mr. Frankie, that video will show you the true colors of this flat earth you're so fond of. Wake up and smell the roses of reality, mate, because this rabbit hole is full of deception, deceit, and isolation, as you're experiencing right now through your strained relationship with your family because of flat earth. Well, there we have it. Another day, another silly. And another chance for you to tickle that bell, subscriber button, comments button, and of course the Patreon and merchandise stuff. Shilling for all it's worth. You gotta give the floor something to talk about, right? Hey, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye! Frankie B. Flat. More like Frankie B. Clueless, but hey, that's his choice.